Hey guys, My Basement Reviews here, and today I'm going to be reviewing the DVD of Star Trek. Now, I bought the 2-disc special edition. It's got this nice little sleeve right here, where just a pretty basic Spock, Kirk cover. Got the inside, it's got the standard old-time Star Trek font. This little booklet, pretty much all this booklet is instructions how to download the digital copy and some information about the video game, which I know nothing about. But I've spent the last couple of days watching all the special features, and I gotta say, this is a must-have for Star Trek fans. I've always enjoyed Star Trek ever since growing up, and I've always been a Kirk fan. I like to say that my dad raised me right. And I remember I saw the teaser trailer for this probably 8 or 9 months before the actual movie came out. And I was really, really excited. And this is one of the few movies where I anticipated it so much that I was actually worried I was going to be greatly disappointed. And actually, when I got out of the theater, it was better than I could have possibly imagined. So, I've always been a Kirk Spock fan, but I wanted to go over some of the special features on this DVD release. There's actually special features on both discs, which is interesting. Disc 1 is obviously the feature film, and Disc 2 is the special features in digital copy, but they actually had, like, the gag reel and a segment called A New Vision, which was like a collection of interviews. I've always loved listening to JJ Abrams talk. I have been a fan of JJ Abrams since Lost. And I remember I watched the behind the scenes of season 1 of Lost, and a lot of the behind the scenes of Star Trek reminded me of that, because he's done some of the same things being the same director. It was always interesting to see. In fact, one of the funniest things about J.J. Abrams is the most intense action sequences are sometimes filmed so simply, it's amazing that they actually are able to pass it off. For instance, during A New Vision, you get to see pretty much a short montage of some of the action sequences where you have stuff going on, the actors playing out, and then you've got a cameraman sitting there. And JJ himself is standing on a ladder behind the cameraman, just smacking the cartridge where the film goes. And it's amazing because you get the most intense camera shakes ever, and they're realistic. I mean, sometimes, you know, I know a lot of movies, they'll do that in post-production. They'll edit the camera shakes in, but JJ's like, nah, I'm just gonna shake this thing. And it's hilarious to see this. And the gag reel was actually pretty funny as well, and there were actually a lot of deleted scenes that I was not anticipating being there. For instance, the deleted scenes included Spock's birth, which initially they cut out just because they wanted to kind of cut to the chase a little bit quicker. But there was one deleted scene that was really intriguing because it was so long, I was amazed that they actually cut it out. And it was pretty much what happened to Nero and his crew during the 25 years he was missing, and it actually showed Klingons, which was interesting. Now, I usually don't do this, but with Star Trek, I actually, as soon as I was done watching the movie, I started it back over and turned on the commentary. The commentary is with J.J. Abrams, Damon Lindelof, Brian Burke, Alex Kurtzman, and Roberto Orci, which, if you're not familiar with them, these are the geniuses behind both Lost and Fringe, which are two of my absolute favorite shows on television right now. Lost is by far the top, but Fringe is great, and these guys are just fantastic filmmakers, and it's sometimes just really, really cool to listen to their thought process. And one of the interesting things is J.J. Abrams was not a fan of Star Trek, which is a little odd, but he was able to collaborate with enough people to get something that I see as completely authentic to the spirit of Star Trek. Also in the commentary, they'll point out some things that you may or may not have noticed during the movie. For instance, they had a throwback to the original Star Trek series with Tribbles. You probably didn't notice it, but they had a couple Tribbles in there, as well as a special Easter egg during one of the action sequences that there's no way you could possibly have caught that unless you were pausing it frame by frame, but it's pretty funny. Okay, so Disc 2 also had a segment called To Boldly Go, which was similar to A New Vision in the sense that it was just a bunch of interviews kind of put together, which was really good. They had a lot of JJ talking and a lot of Leonard Nimoy talking, which was very good. And one of my favorite segments was actually casting, which was pretty much the process that they went through to pick out new actors to play these iconic characters, because that was the one thing that they were worried about. And in my opinion, in this movie, they nailed every role just perfectly. I didn't see a single actor in that movie that I was like, oh, he can't play Chekhov, or oh, he can't play Kirk. That was just a bad decision, because all of the actors in this movie were brilliant. I don't have a single complaint. But one of the things that was particularly touching is the fact that they paid special attention to Leonard Nimoy, because he reprised his role as Spock for the first time in 18 years, and it was really just kind of a heart-tugging moment, because they actually showed when they wrapped the final scene with Leonard Nimoy, and he kind of stood up and gave a small speech, and man, I was tearing up, man. I love Leonard Nimoy. I think he is a fantastic actor, and he was so generous and gracious to everyone in this movie. I mean, I believe he had said he was never going to play Spock again, but after reading the script and talking with JJ and Damon and them, he decided to do it and help them out, and I mean, that made the movie. There was the movie, it still would have been good, but certain aspects of it would have just completely flopped if Leonard Nimoy did not help, so that was something that really touched me. There was also a segment about the alien design, where they pretty much talk about all the makeup and prosthetics going into the alien designs, including, like, apparently Vulcan ears are a lot more complicated than just pointy. And it was interesting going through some of the original designs for Nero and the Romulan crew were just hilarious. but that was a cool segment. They had a lot of really simple stuff, like just masks or makeup and stuff like that. So most of the aliens that you see in the film are actually actors instead of, like, CGI. They also had a special interview with Michael Giacchino, the music composer for Star Trek. He's worked a lot with JJ Abrams. He's scored Lost, Alias, Fringe, Mission Impossible 3. Some of his non-JJ projects include Up and The Incredibles, as well as he's done a ton of video game soundtracks as well. And I absolutely love the score to Star Trek. It really captures the intensity, the energy, and the spirit of Star Trek. Especially, I loved how they did an original score, but towards the end of the movie, they went back to the original theme. They amped it up a little bit, but that was just brilliant. I absolutely love the score of this movie, so. Alright guys, so the Star Trek 2-disc special is a definite must-have for you Star Trek fans. Or if you are not a Star Trek fan, this movie pretty much reestablishes the entire series, so you can start from there, and they've already planned a sequel, and, you know, this movie is quite possibly the best reboot of any franchise I've ever seen, and still my favorite movie of 2009, and has definitely made a spot in my top 10 favorite movie of all time list. So, go out, buy this DVD, let me know what you thought. Since I didn't officially post a review of Star Trek because I wasn't making videos at the time, if you've seen the movie, let me know what you thought. Whether or not you are a Star Trek fan or not, it doesn't really matter. Just, you know, that's one of the beautiful things about this movie. It was able to appeal to non-fans and fans at the same time. So let me know what you thought. Leave any questions or comments in my comment box. You can send me a personal message or post a video response. And I'll talk to you guys later. Thanks for watching.